Namaste! Welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen! Today I'm going to show you a very traditional Gujarati recipe from where I grew up. It is known as patra or pateria. Here I have some fresh patra, also known as taro leaves, also known as arbi in some part of India. So basically these are the leaves I have blooming in my garden. So I thought today I'm going to prepare the patra, also known as pateria. There are different names from different region of India, but we call it patra or pateria.
Take one taro leaf at a time and remove the stem with veins. Here I have all patra ready.
Now if you can't find taro leaves, because I know that it's hard to find in countries like USA, or if you are living abroad other than India, you can try using some other greens, but you want to use the greens that do not get wilted easily. I can recommend also the big leaves of spinach, not the baby spinach, or maybe mustard, or there are some other kale greens you can try with those. This recipe is a really well-crafted recipe in terms of nutrition. It contains a lot of iron, the greens already, and the batter is prepared from besan. Besan is the key flour that is used in this recipe, but these days there are many other flours are added, such as wheat flour. Some people add millet, milo flour, or also corn flour. It's totally up to you if you want to mix flours or you want to use only besan. Basically, besan is chickpea flour or garbanzo beans flour. So I'm going to just share the way we prepare where I grew up, and you can just customize it to your liking then. So let's begin. First step is to prepare the batter. Into this mixing bowl, I'm going to take a cup of a besan, quarter cup of corn flour. I'm not using corn starch, it is corn flour or corn meal. You can use makkai ka aata, or you can use jowar bajra aata or gehu ka aata, but the main flour should be besan. A tablespoon of ground peanut, moongfali. Here I have special garam masala used for this patra making, but if you don't have, you can leave out, or you can use some other kind of garam masala. Ground coriander, cumin, dhania jeera powder, turmeric powder, haldi, red chili powder as per your taste, salt as per taste. Now remember, you want to add some little bit more salt for the leaves as well. 1 teaspoon of sesame seeds if desired. Till. Now this recipe is about sweet and sour as well. So here I have brown sugar. You can use gur, jaggery also known as, or you can use simply any kind of sugar, but I like to use brown sugar. First, give it a good stir to all dry ingredients. Alright, mixed well. And now it's time for wet ingredients. For the wet ingredients, here I have oil. Some people also add garlic paste. So if desired, you can add garlic paste. I'm going to add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. It requires a good amount of oil. Here I have lime. You can add lemon or lime juice. Some people use tamarind, imli for sour taste in this recipe. So it's totally up to you. Very juicy lime I have here. Look at this giant limes blooming in my garden. This lime smells amazing. Alright, so everything is in there. Now add little water at a time, and I'm going to use my hand actually, just one hand is good enough, and mix it really well. Prepare lump-free batter and keep the batter thick.
kind of a paste so that you can spread nicely. Just going to add a little bit of water. So that's just good enough. So it takes very less amount of water, so be careful not to add all at once, but add as you go, as you keep on mixing. The mixture is a bit of a sticky to work with, but tastes amazing. So you want to prepare kind of a consistency that can be spreaded easily on those leaves. This mixture, the aroma is so good here. Okay, it's gonna take a little bit more water, and that should work now. So I'm just going to keep on mixing. So here I have the batter ready. As you can see, it's thick, but this is how I want. And next, take flat plate and take one taro leaf at a time. Actually, the other way is very convenient this way, so I can hold on to this tip and then spread. Make sure your taro leaves, bacteria washed really well. Sometimes they have all kinds of stuff on it, dirt, bugs. So clean them properly, and you have to remove some veins, the thick veins. As you can see, it's already cut here. So you have to prepare your taro leaves really well before using. Okay, so this one is spreaded well. Now take another taro leaf on it. So basically you repeat the same thing. Spread better. One more here. Now it depends on how big you want your bacteria or patra to be when they are done. So once you are done with these, you can steam or you can fry directly. You can shallow fry or deep fry. So there are several options for preparing this, cooking this patra. And today I'm thinking of trying out in air fryer. So as you can see, I'm taking like size by size. The first one was big, then I took a little smaller, then a little smaller, and this one is really small. As you can see, it's not necessary, but it makes the roll kind of a little bit better. But you may not always get the assorted sizes for patra, so not to worry about that. I think I am just going to use about 4 of taro leaves. And now I'm ready to roll. So first I'm going to get those wings in and again spread better on them. Alright, so that's done. Next, the sides, like so. And then prepare tight roll. Now because of the chickpea flour, it is always going to be sticky, and it also helps to keep this taro leaves intact really well. But just to be sure to roll properly. And if you are going to steam, there won't be any problem, even if you haven't rolled really tight. So here I have my first roll ready, as you can see, and I'm going to prepare rest of the rolls. All right, so here I have my last one done. All right, so here I have all the taro leaves rolls ready, patelia or patra. Now, as I said, you can cook this patra in many ways. You can steam, you can shallow fry, deep fry. Here I have my steamer. I'm going to get that ready. Here I have the steaming basket. Add about a liter of water into the steamer. Place the steamer inside the pot, and I usually prefer to grease the tray with oil. Alright, so I have the steamer ready, and I'm going to place the rolls inside the tray and steam for about 25 minutes. Because I have prepared thick rolls, I'm going to steam for 25 minutes. Let me show you how the steam patra looks like. As you can see, nice and steamy. Let them cool, and you can cut in the slices, and then you can deep fry, shallow fry, or you can just give it a tarka, season it however you like, or even just you can eat as it is, the steamed one.
Slice them up, and then you can saute with oil, mustard seeds, coconut, cashews and all that, or you can fry them as well. I have already shared the videos, or you can go to my website.
So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do like and comment below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for new recipe videos every week, and please do visit my website bowness.kitchen.com for new recipe tips, tricks and ideas in the kitchen. Thank you for watching, and see you soon.